Hello, people. I'm Javi Kawei. Joining us today is Perry Nemiroff.
Hi.
She comes from Collider, and she has her own YouTube channel. Nothing, like, pornographic on there. Just, like, good stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Good quality stuff. So today we're going to look at The Fortress, trailer number one. This is from Movie Clips Film Festivals and Indie Films. A great resource if you're looking for something different from the mainstream stuff. Let's check it out. English subtitles. 성 밖에 온통 적들이 깔렸다고도 한다. 전하, 속히 남한산성으로 옥체를 피하소서. 세자를 보내라고. 세자 저하를 불모로 보내지 않으면 화친은 없을 것이라 하였사옵니다. 전하, 명기는 지금 세자 저하를 욕보이고 나가 전하를 능멸하고 있사옵니다. 명기에 지금 세자 저하를 보내지 않으시면 저들이 더 큰 욕을 해올까? 신은 그것이 두렵사옵니다. 정령 전하께서는 칸의 신하가 되시겠사옵니까? 전하, 만백성과 함께 죽음을 각오하지 마시옵소서. 나는 살고자 한다. 명기이 말하는 삶은 곧 죽음이옵니다. 그럼 또 어쩌라는 것이냐? 하룻밤을 버티지 못하고 어찌 먼저 무릎을 꿇으려 하시옵니까? 조선의 백성들은 아무런 잘못이 없습니다. 어떤 일도겠지. 지수입니다. 지금 군사들은 모두 죽일 순 없습니다. 제발 공격을 멈추시오. 내가 이 일을 해내면 성안에 모두가 살 수 있다.
The scope of that looked like something else.
Yeah.
Much bigger than I was anticipating.
I wasn't sure where the trailer was going for a second. I'm like, is this what they do the whole movie? Just talk about whether or not they're going to go? Like, I was genuinely concerned for a second, but then you see like the epic war sequences and whatnot. I'm like, oh, okay. It's just not showing you as much, which I appreciate.
Yeah.
Like, it's a minute and 30 seconds of this epic war film. I like when they, you know, keep some mystery in there, but that one shot was super cool when it was like using the drone shot just flying through the war. That reminds me of an old video game I played back in the day. I forget what it's called. It's from PlayStation 2 or something. It had a cool cutscene just like that where it went through a war. At the time, I'm like, that would be so cool if you had a shot like that with live action. And then there they did it and it looked really good.
At first, I thought this was going to look maybe a little cheap because sometimes when you don't have a movie being produced by a gigantic Hollywood studio that you're really familiar with, you see these epic war movies and they're not done as well as they could have because of resources.
Right.
That was something else, though. The fact that you have so many people to coordinate in those gigantic battle sequences.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not just small fighting between one or two people. Those were big freaking armies going at it, and it all looked really good.
Yeah. The choreography and the coordination, the timing of it all was just on point. It was moving quick, but like when that shot was going over, I'm like, it looked like they were all really going head-to-head independent choreography for all of them. It looked really, really good.
Yeah, that's not easy stuff to coordinate, especially when you have so many planes of action happening, and that's what they have. Every single thing had scope. That looks kind of good. I'm happy that you shared that with me, because I was completely unaware of The Fortress.
Yeah, and then like those intense shots of the acting and whatnot going on. Like, the Korean films I've been watching lately have just been remarkable. There was like a Korean film I saw in cinemas not too long ago. I had the good fortune of the film company or like whoever was responsible for marketing paying for us to go watch it because they really wanted us to see it and do a review on it. And they're like, do you know your honest review on it? And I'm like, hey, look, you say that to me, but like, thankfully, it was such a good film. And so it's like, I'm more and more intrigued with Korean films as time goes on. You ever see Old Boy?
Of course I've seen Old Boy.
Yeah. I would like
Old Boy is intense.
That scared me away from Korean films for a while.
There's a couple of them out there that have made me a little nervous also because you know I'm really into horror and some of those horror movies are very, very brutal.
Yeah, like they don't pull their punches. That's what intrigues me about this because I know that it's going to be an action drama that doesn't pull its punches. So I'm happy to check it out.
Yeah, I'm curious.
You guys, please do me a favor. Check out Perry Nemiroff on the social media. Subscribe to her YouTube channel. She's got her own YouTube videos and she's in desperate need of more subscribers. That's the whole reason why she's here right now.
No, it's because you're cool too.
I'm just joking. Yeah, but subscribe to this channel as well. If you haven't already, check out our other reactions, reviews, and short films. I'm Javi Kawei. This is
Perry Nemiroff.
Peace out.